Welcome to Randolph High School. I'm Jeffrey Pickett alongside Josh Brown, bringing you coverage of the Stoughton High Boys Basketball team's game against the Randolph High Blue Devils in what will be the championship game of the Blue Devils Holiday Classic. Stoughton got to this championship game with a 56-48 victory against Natick in what was an exciting game. They meet Randolph, and Stoughton will be looking to improve to 2-3 on the season. The Black Knights enter this contest with a 1-3 mark, so they're looking to end the 2013 part of this schedule on a high note. We'll be right back with starting lineups, the national anthem, and the opening tip. Tip coming up from Randolph. Stoughton High boys basketball team are in their all-black road uniforms with orange lettering. Randolph is in their home uniforms, which are white with royal blue numbering. Josh, final thoughts before tip?
You got to build off that momentum you carried up on Saturday. You come in here on, you know, a one-game winning streak the first of the year. You got to build off of that. You got Stoughton did a pretty good job on the boards last game. You got to pick that up. And if they can do that all, I think it's a tough game. Randolph's a good team, but I think if you can do all that, then Stoughton has a pretty good chance of picking up their second game of the year here tonight.
Thank you, Josh, as the players make their way onto the court for the opening tip. Starting five for Stoughton, Stanley Sages, Mike Gallagher, Joey Wilder, Mike Manning, and Dennis Ribello. Wilder at midcourt for the tip, going up against Fritz Olsen for the Blue Devils. And Stoughton controls the opening tip as Mike Manning gets the ball. Manning back to Gallagher. Gallagher at the point, bringing the ball across the half-court line. Gallagher to Mike Manning. Manning going inside, driving, and he gets a two to start the game. Mike Manning going to the bucket. He's an outside shooter, but showing that he can also go inside there for the opening score. Stoughton up 2-0 early.
Good pick by Wilder there to give him that lane to the basket.
That's Olsen with a shot, and that's good, so it's a tie game. Excuse me, that's Oslin. Fritz Oslin, the captain for Randolph. Inbounds pass goes to Stanley Sages. Sages bringing the ball past the half-court line. Sages now near the top of the key. 20 seconds left on the shot clock. And nearly a backcourt violation. It is a backcourt violation. That was good defense by Tariq Alassa, who forced Sages to go behind the half-court line for the violation.
Yeah, good defense here. They swarmed Stanley. He was trying to get the ball to a guard, and he just couldn't do it. Good defense there.
Fred Epps, another captain from Randolph, controls the ball. Now Anthony Fernandez has it at the top of the key. Back to Epps, who's guarded by Manning. Matt Brown with a shot. It's going to be no good, and Stoughton comes up with a rebound. That's Sages. Stanley Sages with the ball. He's tightly defended. Sages gets it back. Again, double teamed underneath the basket. He's going to draw the foul.
Good job by Sages here. He recognized the double team, rolled to the basket, and got a free kind of shot up there. Randolph fouled him, but good job by Sages to have that awareness to get open there.
Stanley Sages at the line, shooting a free throw. First attempt is good. Sages for the second attempt, clanks off, and Randolph gets the rebound. A 3-2 lead early on for Stoughton, a minute and a half into this contest. Mike Manning with the defense right now for Stoughton. Travel called on the court against Randolph, so it'll be Stoughton ball. Mike Gallagher will be inbounding. Gallagher looking to get the ball in, gets it to Mike Manning. Manning gets it back to Gallagher. Tight defense by Randolph here. Manning gets it across the half-court line, though, to Sages. And Sages is working his way inside. Shot no good, but Wilder comes up with a rebound, and Joey Wilder puts it back in. Nice move by Joey Wilder, who is proving to be a rebound machine early on this season. That's Matt Brown for three behind the line. He gets it. Matt Brown ties this game up at five. Just under 6 minutes to play in the first quarter. Mike Manning with the ball. Brings it across the half-court line. Manning now going inside. Drives to the basket. Shot no good. Dennis Ribello, though, is going to track down the rebound. Dennis Ribello, some tight defense on him. I'm noticing that early on from this Randolph squad. Some pressure defense. Mike Gallagher with the ball. Just 7 seconds left on the shot clock. Manning with the ball. Somebody's going to have to put up a shot. Just 2 seconds left. Gallagher from a long range three. Loose ball, and Randolph comes up with it. That's Fred Epps bringing the ball across the half court line and to the basket. And Fred Epps floats one up there, and it's good. 7-5 Randolph. Manning controls the ball for Stoughton. Brings the ball across the half-court line and gets it to Joey Wilder. Wilder looking to pass the ball. Almost loses it. Now is the lane inside, and Joey Wilder takes it and gets the shot. Joey Wilder, nice move right there.
Yeah, good move by Wilder. Randolph, if you can get them off, if you can kind of shake them off, they're not a very athletic team. They're a team that likes to use their defense to get on transition. So good job by Joey recognizing that and getting to the hoop.
Randolph shot no good. Mike Manning with the rebound. Stoughton, a good rebounding team. They showed that against Natick in the first game of this tournament. Rebella with the ball. Gets it to Sages. Sages working his way inside, and Sages' shot won't fall, but Gallagher gets the rebound. Kicks it out to Manning. Manning for three. No good. And Randolph with the rebound. That's Epps. Epps working his way to the basket. Puts up a shot, and it's good. So it's 9-7 Randolph. Sages gets the ball. Going to bring the ball across the half-court line to Wilder. Joey Wilder looking to kick the ball out. Gets it to Mike Gallagher, who's going to reset with 15 left on the shot clock. Oh, inside pass to Manning, but that is swatted away.
Yeah, Manning, good job by Manning to get open. Just a little slow to get that shot up. And a good job by the Randolph defense to go over and swat. Again, Randolph's a really good defensive team. They're very fast and they can stay with you, Wilson. Stoughton's got to figure something out to kind of shake them off.
And the inbounds pass is stolen, but loose ball. Randolph ultimately comes up with it, going to the hoop. And no good. Looks like Randolph touched it last. That was 21, Terrell Davis going to the hoop. Gallagher with the inbounds pass. Sages across the half court line. Sages working his way around the court. Gets it to Wilder. And there's some contact.
Trying to go down low here, Coach Gallivan's looking like they're trying to get buckets down low and try to make it fouled.
And they do just that, but the pass is a little errant and Joey Wilder can't come up with it, so a turnover for Stoughton. Randolph has the ball. Miles Graham controlling it. Gets it out to Brown. Brown to Ralph Podio. And that was Terrell Davis with a shot no good. Stoughton comes up with a rebound. Stanley Sages with the ball. And Stanley Sages trying to go to the hoop but loses control of it. Gallagher gets it though. Gallagher inside to Wilder, and Wilder is going to draw some contact. Like you said, Josh, just about a minute ago. Stoughton clearly trying to go inside in this game, and Joey Wilder will be a focal point of this offense.
Yeah, Wilder, if he can get to the free throw line, really establish himself as, you know, a good free throw shooter tonight, that would be huge for Stoughton, because it might make Randolph back off a little bit, be a little more less hesitant to foul, and it would open up a lot of doors for Stoughton.
Wilder misses the first free throw attempt. Randolph has a 9-7 lead with just under 3 minutes left in this first quarter. We're here at the finals of the Blue Devil Holiday Classic between the Stoughton High boys basketball team and the Randolph High basketball team. Wilder misses the second free throw. As good of a rebounding team as Stoughton is, free throws are not their strength. They missed a number of them down the stretch against Natick in the first game of this holiday tournament. That's Matt Brown working his way inside. Can't get the shot to fall. Dennis Rebello with the rebound. Rebello controlling the ball, bringing it across the half-court line. Again, some tight one-on-one defense for Randolph. Wilder now with the ball. 15 seconds left on the shot clock. Wilder working his way inside. Gets it to Gallagher. And Gallagher finishes it to tie the game.
Wilder got fouled, too, on that pass. Good job by him. Still getting the pass off to Gallagher.
Yeah, no call there. But the game is tied as Gallagher does convert. Terrell Davis now working his way to the hoop, and Terrell Davis puts up a floater, no good. Mike Manning fighting for the rebound and gets it. Mike Manning across the half-court line. He has the ball stolen away from him, though. They're going to call a jump ball.
Jump ball.
So the possession arrow pointing towards Randolph, so Randolph ball. That second defender, Josh, just kind of came out of nowhere.
Yeah, and Randolph likes to do that. They like to swarm you and try to create a lot of pressure. Again, they're not a team that's really offensively gifted, so they try to do it with their defense, and they do a good job of it.
Matt Brown with the ball. Joey Wilder with the defense. Gets out to Fred Epps. Brandon Teixeira has checked into the game for Stoughton. He's number 11. That's Matt Brown with the shot. No good, but Randolph gets the rebound. Epps with the ball. Again, Teixeira with the defense. Epps loses control of it, but still, he gets it back. He's going to the hoop, and they're going to call an offensive foul. You have to give credit to Mikey Gallagher right there for drawing the charge.
Yeah, Coach Goulston, he drives home taking charges, and Mikey Gallagher did just that.
Joey Wilder with the ball. Mike Gallagher now across the half-court line. Gallagher trying to score, can't get it. Sam Werman has checked into the game too for Stoughton, number 34. Randolph has the ball on a mini-fast break, and that was Fred Epps going coast-to-coast for the score. 11-9, Randolph leads in this back-and-forth first quarter. Inbounds pass goes to Werman. Werman looking to get the ball. He gets it to his share. Under 1 minute to play in this first quarter as Teixeira has the ball. Teixeira to Werman. Werman looking to pass, gets it to Gallagher. Gallagher working his way back inside, now back out. 7 seconds left on the shot clock. Joey Wilder for a rare three-pointer. Oh. Stoughton grabs a rebound though, can't get it to go. Another rebound, Stanley Sage just draws a foul. Well, that's Stoughton's rebound, keeping that possession alive. Like Joey Wilder taking a three, that's even he'll tell you that's not a shot that he would want to take. So good job Stoughton taking advantage of getting the rebounds and putting themselves in a position to score here. They had to get a shot off with just a couple seconds left. You have to credit Randolph's defense, Josh.
Wilder had Gallagher actually open in the corner. He didn't see him there, so good job by Joey to get the shot. And good job by Stanley to follow that shot. To, you know, get the fresh shot clock, go right back up with it and get fouled.
So Stanley Sages makes his first free throw attempt. It's an 11-10 game. 37.3 seconds left in this first quarter. Sages looking to tie the game. Clanks out. Randolph with the rebound. Some contact. Fritz Oslin will inbound the ball for Randolph. Gets it in. Miles Graham with the ball now. Kicks it out to Shamar Murray, who just checked in, and he goes to the bucket. Can't get it to go, though. Draws some contact, though. Stoughton doesn't really foul much, Josh, for a team that likes to rebound and likes to be aggressive under the boards.
Yeah, no, I think sometimes maybe they should even foul a little bit more than they do. Sometimes it's not that bad. You know, give them a little nudge on the shot. I think sometimes Stoughton gives up a kind of soft basket. So then fouling would be something that Stoughton could maybe, you know, don't excessively foul, obviously, but I think a foul here and there could work to Stoughton's benefit.
Murray goes 1-for-2 at the free throw line. Stoughton will hold for the last shot of the quarter. It's Gallagher with the ball now. 12 seconds left, Sages with the ball. 10 now, Sam Werman has the ball. 5 seconds left, out to Sages. They're gonna need to get a shot off. Sages. Stanley Sages right there, again, heads up play. Really a shot that, percentage-wise, small chance of making, but he knows he has to get a shot up. And with Randolph's aggressive defense, Sages taking advantage of it, and he draws some contact. He's going to get, he's going to get to go to the line when if there was no contact on that play, he just would have missed a shot. Sages makes the first. There's less than a second left in this quarter, so effectively, as soon as Sages is done shooting these free throws, the inbounds pass will end this quarter. Sages misses the next one. One more for Sages, who was behind the three-point line. And Sages makes it, so we're gonna have a tie game, 12-12. So at the end of the first quarter, Stoughton is tied with Randolph at 12 apiece. we're back for a second quarter coverage. Stoughton 12, Randolph 12. As we start the second quarter, I'm going to hand the mic to Josh Brown for the play-by-play.
Thanks, Jeff. So we're here to begin the second quarter, a 12-12 game here from Randolph. You have Gallagher, Manning, Ribello, Sejus, and Teixeira in for Stoughton. They get the pass into Manning. Manning looking to Sejus. They have Ribello open on the right side. Sejus decides to take his own, puts up a little layoff. He misses. Rebound Randolph. Here comes Randolph, Miles Graham sprinting across the other end. They kick it out to Oslam. Oslam takes a 20-foot jump shot. He misses. Rebound Manning. Manning doing a good job getting out in transition. To Sejus, right side, back to Manning. They get to Sejus in the corner. He looked for Gallagher, couldn't find anything. Takes it himself, kicks it out to Teixeira. Left side, three, nope. Rebound Randolph. Graham speeding it ahead for Randolph. Gallagher on him. They get to Fernandez, his shot misses. Rebound Randolph, good offensive rebound there by them. Graham, he's working down to Oslam. Oslam puts up a shot, good rebound Sejus there. And he'll take it over half court. Sejus, good move by him. He puts up a turnaround jump shot. He misses. Rebound Manning. His shot is blocked. And Randolph comes down with it. Randolph in transition. Loose ball picked up by Manning. Good job by Ribello to slap that ball away. So I'm looking to slow it down a little bit here.
That's exactly what they need to do. This game's getting a little fast for both sides right now.
Yeah, both teams, I think Stoughton especially would benefit from slowing this game down, kind of running their offense. So Randolph's going to take over. 6:24 left in the second in a 12-12 tie. Coach Gallivan coaching against his former coaching mate, Kalon Jenkins. Graham with Gallagher working on him. They get it down to number 30, Bryant Benzel. Stolen Gallagher with the ball up in transition. And again, the ball is stolen. Randolph, little layup, Graham. He misses, rebound to Sejus. And Stoughton really needs to slow this game down, Jeff.
Absolutely. Randolph needed to finish on that end. They had a great chance to do so and just really aren't converting on offense right now.
Problem is Stoughton isn't either on their end. Here's Manning. He drives baseline, puts up a reverse layup, and he's fouled.
What I'm seeing from Mike Manning early on, working his way inside. Like I said, likes to shoot a lot from the outside, but he's showing that he will go inside. He's drawing some contact, and it looks like that's where Stoughton's going to have to be generating some of its offense right now.
Manning, a pretty good free throw shooter, makes the first. Wilder back into the game for Sejus. 13-12 Stoughton. Manning. Makes both. A rarity we've seen from Stoughton this tournament, a shooter making both free throws, but Mike Manning does just that, giving Stoughton a 14-12 lead. Gallagher on Codio. They kick it to Oslam. His three is off. Scrum for the rebound. Teixeira picks it up, and he's in transition. He has Ribello with him. He's taking it to himself. Ball stripped away, stolen by Randolph. Now Randolph has numbers. They slow it down. Epps, they kick it to Davis. Davis shot misses, rebound Randolph, gets it back to him, and he's fouled. And one, what a shot by Davis. He put it, an awkward shot while he's falling down, put it right up and converted on the foul. Great shot there by number 20, Ralph Codio there. Just a lucky break there for Randolph.
And that's also a tough foul to commit to. It's almost a little too little too late, and you end up being over aggressive at the end and drawing the contact.
That tied the game at 14. Codio doesn't get the bounce. man and gets it ahead to Ribello. He has an open three. Missed it. Probably should have stepped in another step there before taking it. Rebound to Randolph. Epps. He's going to take it himself and put it up. His shot's no good. Rebound, Manning. Good job by Ribello to get that tip to him. Manning now coming up the right side. Looking for Correa down low. They get it to Ribello out on the wing. Ribello, free throw line, jump shot, and he gets the good and one. Back-to-back sequences there. Randolph got a good and one on there, and Ribello comes right back two possessions later and gets a good one of his own.
Sweet shot right there, and just a lucky roll-in. That was one of those ones where it just seemed to take forever to get into the basket. But lucky for Stoughton, it did.
Ribello makes his free throw. Good job by Stoughton making their free throw so far. 17-14 Stoughton, 4:39 left in the half. Here's Epps. Randolph trying to work the ball down low. Epps now has it in the corner. He's going to pull up. Misses it badly. Rebound by Gallagher. They get it to Manning. Manning looking to Ribello, right corner. Ribello now trying to push his way off a Randolph defender. He doesn't. Shot's blocked. Gallagher now has it. Nothing really doing for Stoughton offensively in this possession. Can't really generate anything. Ribello going to try to bail him out with a shot. He misses. Rebound to Randolph. And Epps is going to take it up court. So nothing really going on that offensive possession. They get it to Brown. Brown's three, misses wide. Rebound Wilder, but a foul is going to be called on him. They give the foul to Gallagher on the push down low. Looked like if anyone should have had a foul there, with Wilder, but regardless, Coach Jenkins is going to use his first time out of the night. So 3:41 left in the second, 17-14 Stoughton.
Too bad for Stoughton on that previous drive, not being able to take advantage and getting what would be their first multiple possession lead of the game. You know, not that you break the game open leading by 5 or 6 points, but just to give them a little bit of breathing room. And this has really been a bucket for bucket contest since the opening tip.
Yeah, I like this matchup of teams. They're both kind of teams who have quick guards but have some height down low. So I think this was the right matchup for this final. Stoughton can keep getting out in transition, getting easy buckets, then they should have the upper hand here because they're a little bit quicker than Randolph. They have a little bit more height, so I think that they can keep doing that. And you know, the boards can keep coming down for Stoughton. I think they have a good shot to pull this one out.
Well said, Josh.
3:41 left until half. Randolph's ball out of the timeout. You have Wilder, Correa, Manning, Ribello, Gallagher. Stoughton going small here. Maybe trying to get out in transition. Get a couple of easy buckets to end the half here. Brown's going to inbound. He gets it into Epps. Epps shot, no good. Rebound to Correa. He gets it to Gallagher. Seju's getting ready to check back in. Wilder, good pass down low to Ribello. He wasn't ready for it. He gets composure. Gets it to Correa for three. Correa, good. Junior Correa, as his teammates call him, gives him a 20-14 lead with 3:15 left in the half. Randolph now working down low. They kick it out. Here's Murray. Kicks it back out to Brown. Brown's shot misses badly. Offensive rebound, Randolph. Brown now setting back out to Epps. Brown now driving on Ribello. He puts up a tough shot, misses, rebound Ribello. Manning going to try to dump it ahead to Correa. Correa to Wilder down low. His shot, pass is knocked away. Gallagher gets it. Gallagher's going to reset. Wilder now. Kicks it to Manning. Manning thought about shooting it. He takes a step in, takes a shot, misses. Out of bounds, rebound to Randolph. Graham and Oslam come in for Randolph. Seju's for Stoughton. Both teams try and get a little bit more height out there. Here's Graham, sophomore. To Brown. Brown kicks it down low. Randolph, layup. They miss it. Rebound Wilder. Joey having another big game on the boards. Manning looking. He gets it to Ribello. Top of the key there. Ribello to Gallagher. Good defense here by Randolph. They get it back to Manning. Seven on the shot clock. Manning spins away from him. His ball is loose and steal by Randolph. Randolph now taps. Good tap. Down to number 20, Ralph Codio. Good job there by Brown to tip the ball to him. And Randolph all of a sudden pulls within four. Gallagher now taking the ball up. They get it down low to Sages. Knocked away. Stoughton will keep possession. Jeff, turnovers really hurting Stoughton here.
Absolutely. Sages needed to corral that ball underneath. He was open. Would have had a great chance of scoring right there. Stoughton needs to cut down on the turnover.
Yeah. That shot is airballed. Rebound goes down to Randolph. Graham almost out of bounds. Graham throws it off Wilder's legs. Lucky for Randolph. They recover. Airball. Rebound Gallagher. Gallagher here. He gets in the lane for a layup. Not, doesn't go. Rebound Wilder. He puts it back up for two. Again, Joey Wilder on the glass getting that rebound and finishing. Seconds left here in the half. Offensive foul there on Randolph. Didn't see who it was on. But Stoughton's going to get the ball back with 43 seconds and a 22-16 lead. Gallagher tried to kick it out and they got a charge. Good play there by Randolph. Number 5, Matt Brown was waiting there for a decade for Gallagher, and he did a good job taking that charge there. Gallagher, good job trying to kick that pass out, but Brown, kind of a big figure. He looks bigger than he really is, and good job by him to take that charge. Randolph can get the clock down to 3 if they decide to hold. Jenkins looks like he wants to get a shot off. Not enough time for a 2-on-1 here, for 2-for-1 here for Randolph. They feed it down to Oslam. Good defense there by Stoughton. Brown with the ball now. Graham, he takes a long 3. He's way off. Rebound Sages. He has Manning wide open, decides to keep it himself. Take the last shot. Here's Sages. Kicks to Wilder. Wilder puts up a layup. He misses, and at the half, a 22-16 lead for Stoughton. Good job by Stoughton to kind of get momentum and take control of that second quarter. Come in the half with a lead. And we're back here for second half. Coverage just about a minute and a half away from the start of the third quarter. Stoughton has a 22-16 lead. We're here broadcasting the Stoughton High Boys Basketball Team's game against the Randolph Blue Devils in the finals of the Blue Devils Holiday Classic. I'm Jeffrey Pickett alongside Josh Brown. Pat Jackman is filming for us. Let's go over some first half stats. For Randolph, the leading scorer in the first quarter was Epps, who had 6 points. But then nobody scored on the Randolph team in the second quarter except for Ralph Codio, who had 4 points. On the Stoughton side, the scoring's really evenly distributed. Joey Wilder has 6 points. Jose Correa has 3 points. Stanley Sages has 4 points, all from the line. Mike Manning has 4 points. Dennis Ribello has 3 points. And Mike Gallagher has 2 points. So really, nobody's really taken the bulk of the scoring yet. So Josh, I'm going to hand it back to you for third quarter play-by-play duties. So Josh,
What do you look for the Stoughton High basketball team to do in the second half?
So, I think a little bit more of the same. They've done, as we said, a good job rebounding to start off. They've done a decent job getting out in transition scoring. So if they can kind of put that all together for one more half, I think they'll be good and should be a win in the Randolph tournament for them. So they have Gallagher, Wilder, Ribello, Sejus, and Manning in for Stoughton. ...22-16 Stoughton. Oslam going to inbound for Randolph to begin the half. And Epps is going to take it off, and we're underway. Epps. Oslam trying to get work down on Sages. They get him the ball, tipped away to Manning, and Stoughton will have possession. Manning. To Wilder around the free throw line. They get it down. Good pass to Gallagher. He swings to Ribello. Ribello three off the mark. Good job by Epps to tip it away. He has Ribello one on one, and Epps puts it in. Not a good job rebounding here by Stoughton. They lackadaisically tried to get to the ball, and that's what happens. Easy layup for Epps there. 22-18 Stoughton. Manning taking it up to Ribello. Seju. He's going to drive to the hoop himself and charge. Clear charge there by Seju. And another good job there. It was again a second charge of the game taken by Matt Brown. And Seju clears day charge there. So Stoughton not the way they want to begin this quarter.
That's unlike the last game in this holiday tournament against Natick, where Stoughton had a very strong start to both the third and the fourth quarters.
Brown to Oslam, to Brown. Randolph, shots off. Oslam to Brown, to Fernandez. Ball back in the hands of Epps. Fernandez. Oslam, he can't catch a pass. Ribello gets it, knocked down, foul on Oslam. Sequence here for Oslam, kind of getting the bad short of a good hustle play by him, but works in Stoughton's favor. Gallagher, they get it to Ribello. Seju. To Manning, Manning in the corner. Gets it down low to Gallagher. Manning. Looking, nothing going on this possession either. Sejus and Ribello crowded up. Ribello tries to bring in for two. His shot's off. Rebound goes to Austin. Epps now pushing it across half court. He's going to get an easy layup in to Ribello. On Ribello. And Randolph cuts within two.
After scoring 4 points in the entire second quarter, Randolph has 4 points in the last 2 minutes of play to start this third.
Randolph really coming out energized. Sejus, now his pass is going to be deflected. Randolph gets it to Epps. Epps and Fernandez on the run for Randolph. Epps puts it up. Shots missed. Jump ball. Ribello did a good job of hanging on the ball there long enough to get the jump ball, and Stoughton will keep possession with that jump ball. And Coach Gallivan's going to call a timeout. So with 5:32 left in the third, 22-20 Randolph. Stoughton, 22-20 Stoughton.
So Randolph's picked up the pace offensively a little bit, and Stoughton's going to need to do the same, as the Black Knights seem to be very either lackadaisical underneath, or they're just losing possession of the ball. They need to really pick up the moment, pick up the intensity inside, get back to doing what they were doing well. I mean, they weren't, by any means, they weren't having a great offensive game, but they were doing enough. Right now, they're not.
Yeah, and credit to Randolph coming out with the spark there. Stoughton looking to pick up their second win of the year. First one came on Saturday against Natick.
after an 0-3 start to end the 2013 part of your schedule, 2-3, I mean, that'd be big for Stoughton going forward. It would be a great turn of events to start 2014.
Hopefully Stoughton too could carry that momentum into the new year. Need a win here first, though. Gallagher gets it into Manning. Randolph applying full court pressure here. Manning gets it down low to Wilder. This ball is knocked away off the knee of Wilder and Randolph fall. Stoughton needs to do a better job of protecting the ball down there. Randolph gets their hands in and is getting their hands in the foot, knocking out the ball every time Stoughton has possession of it.
And it's preventing Stoughton from having one of its greatest strengths, which is the offensive rebounding, just rebounding in general when you're losing the ball like that.
Epps, he dribbles the ball off his foot and Stoughton will get the ball right back.
Coach Gallivan, after a game last season, said that it set the offense, like they set the offensive game back by, 10 years. You can kind of say the same about tonight's game. It's not a pretty offensive game for either side right now.
Gallagher, he gets it in the Wilder. That ball's knocked loose. Gallagher gets it back. Good pass by Gallagher behind the back to Wilder to get over half court. Wilder going coast to coast and he gets fouled. Jenkins wants a travel. Looked like Wilder only took two steps there and made a good play to get that shot up. Good pass by Gallagher though, set up that fast break there for Wilder.
Gotta convert these free throws though. If you're gonna be sent to the line, Stoughton needs to make these if that's gonna be their offense.
Wilder makes the first, 23-20, Stoughton, just under 5 to go. Third quarter here from the Randolph Holiday Tournament. Wilder makes the second. Gives Stoughton a 4-point lead. Fernandez going to take the ball up for Randolph. Brown. Manning working on Epps, they get to Fernandez. Open three, Fernandez, good. Randolph pulls within the 24-23. About halfway done here in the third quarter. Ribello now taking the ball up. Fernandez now defending Gallagher. Wilder out to get the pick, so Sejus uses Sejus. They get to Manning. Manning open three, off. Rebound goes to Brown. Brown trying to get to Murray. Good job by Gallagher to steal. Feeds to Wilder for two. Great play there by Mikey Gallagher.
Where did Mike Gallagher come from on that? He just flew in there for the steal.
Brown. Ribello on Brown. Brown gets the lane. Foul. Sejus picks up the block there. Ribello. They give it to Ribello. Both Ribello and Sejus went down. They give it to Ribello. Brown gonna shoot two, down three here. Brown runs out on the first. Misses the second two, rebound to Seju. He's going to take it over himself. Good defense there by Brown on him. Ribello has it now. He's double-teamed. They get it out to Seju. He loses the ball, and it's knocked out of bounds. Sloppy ball handling again by Stoughton.
There's just so much pressure they have to deal with. Whoever has the ball, it seems, has at least two guys on them.
Stoughton's got to do a better job breaking the double-team, finding the open man. Here's Epps. They get it to Brown. Brown, another open three. This time off the mark. Rebound Fernandez. Epps now. He's looking for a pick. Murray gives it to him. Epps now to Brown. Brown, he's won a shot in the paint. He lost it. They get it to Fernandez in the right corner. Brown now. open three. That one rims long. Rebound Gallagher. Good job boxing out there by Stoughton. Korea ready to check in for Stoughton. Codio for Randolph. Ribello. He's going left, gets to the hoop, dishes to Wilder. Wilder misses, but fouled. Ribello, good unselfish play there. He could have put up the layoff, but dished it down to Wilder, who was open right under the basket there, and he'll get to the line for two. Wilder misses the first one. Six-23, Stoughton, 2:48 left in the third. Wilder misses both. Awesome with the rebound. They get it to Graham. Graham trying to speed things up here. Fernandez gets it down to Awesome. Awesome up, and we'll go to the line for two. Awesome can pull Randolph within one here. He misses the first short. Long, short on the first, long on the second. 0 for 2. Stoughton's still up 3 with 2:35 left in the third. Gallagher with Fernandez working on. He gets around him, kicks it to Wilder. Wilder to Manning. They reset. Gallagher going to go baseline, put up an awkward shot. He misses it. Rebound. Batted away. Jump ball, and it's going to be Randolph ball.
Great heads-up play right there by Mike Gallagher, because even though the possession arrow was going towards Randolph, just being able to jump in there and try to get possession of it now makes the possession arrow go back in favor of Stoughton. It's little things like that.
Awesome was dribbling with it. He just lost the ball and fell on his own. No contact there. Stoughton gets it back. Gallagher gets it to Korea. Korea with a good job on Awesome there, and he throws it away.
Oh, give and take. I was just saying that Stoughton, it's the little things like what Mike Gallagher did on the other end that can help you win a game, but it's a giveaway right back for Stoughton.
It was Korea after that. Great defense on Awesome. Looks like they're chinning Awesome. Someone's going to be on him the whole length of the court. It's Korea right now. Randolph now, right side. Murray puts up a shot. He misses. Rebound Manning. Showing guards doing another great job of rebounding tonight. All five guys on the boards on every shot for Stoughton. Manning. Tough pressure on him. He throws the ball away. Murray. He throws the ball away. So Gallagher gets the ball back. Wilder, lazy pass there. Awesome. Knocked it away. Randolph ball. Sloppy play by both teams there. Epps to check back in for Randolph. He comes in for Fernandez.
We're at a minute 28 left in the third quarter, and neither team has cracked 30 points yet.
Defensive game here and a sloppy game as well. Epps, they get it to Graham. Swing pass to Murray. Murray with Wilder on him. He dumps it to Oslam. Oslam, good work on Korea. And they call him for a push-off. Didn't look like the right call there, but a good break for Stoughton. They called Oslam on a push-off.
Play control foul number 11. Fritz Oslam, his fourth, team fourth.
That's a tough call on Randolph's best player for his fourth foul to call him on a call like that. Seemed like a soft call from here, but Stoughton will certainly take it. Ribello now loses the ball, lazy dribbling there by Stoughton. Ribello, then he gets his pass deflective. Wilder gets it, and he's able to get to the basket with no defense at all. Jeff, this has been a really weird game, especially the second half.
Absolutely. Good job, though, by Joey Wilder there finishing up. You're going to need to get points like that when they're given opportunities like that are given to you. Timeout on the floor.
And, Jeff, this looks like a game you'd find from a third-grade travel team. Two travel teams going on with all the loose balls, you know, the dribbling out of control, and just a very weird game. Here from Randolph. Stoughton, if they can do a better job of keeping ball possession, Randolph isn't playing with any discipline at all. If they can do a better job keeping the ball, Stoughton should have no problem in the fourth quarter kind of running away with this game.
Yeah, it's hard to say, though, when it's Stoughton. Neither team has been able to string together multiple possessions in a row of quality offensive play. Sometimes it's scoring by mistake. Sometimes it's just benefiting from picking up a loose ball. But you have to give credit. This is the type of game it is, and Stoughton, to their credit, is the better team right now. They're up by five, and they're doing just enough to continually stay ahead by a couple buckets.
Just enough here for Stoughton, if Jeff said that Stoughton plays like this going in their Hockamocks side. When they get to the Hockamocks schedule, that's not going to fare well for them. Ribello, Manning, Correa, Wilder, Gallagher. Same lineup as we went into the timeout with. We have 45 seconds left here in the third. 28-23. Stoughton. Both Sejus and Oslam here kind of banged up a little bit. Oslam with the four fouls as well. And just a horrible pass there by Randolph. Nowhere in the direction of number 22. Mackey worry, so Stoughton will get the ball back.
Coming off a timeout like that, that's pretty tough for Randolph to have a possession like a big mistake. Let's see if Stoughton can capitalize.
So that would be big for Stoughton to kind of, it might be a sort of a deflating basket if Stoughton can get another one before the half. Epps on Manning. They get it to Wilder. Wilder blows right by him, up and one. Good job by Joey Wilder to blow by Brian Brenzel, the slower defender, and get that in one.
Stoughton, we talked about just going over the statistics in the first half. Nobody was really, you know, distinguishing themselves in the stat sheet. Joey Wilder is starting to take control of this game inside for Stoughton. And if he can continue to do that in the fourth quarter, Stoughton could be on its way to its second victory.
I'm surprised even when Awesome was in the game, they didn't play him on Wilder. They're both very physical players. Jenkins didn't put him on, and Wilder's done a great job of taking advantage of that, sinking that free throw to give Stoughton a 31-23 lead with 27 seconds left in the third. Jenkins, doesn't look like they're going to hold for the last shot. They want to get one off. Here's Epps. Now they slow it down a little bit. Epps tries to get back down to Brazel. Brazel puts up a shot. He misses, gets his own rebound, puts it in and one. Randolph with a shot to cut the lead down to five with the free throw here. Brazel shooting it for Randolph. Werman checks into the game for Correa. Correa did a good job on Oslam when Awesome was in the game. Brazel's shot, way off, air ball. Stoughton will get the ball with 11 seconds to work with. They want to get Korea back in for this last possession here for Warman. A little offense or defense substitution there. Manning. He gets it into Correa. Correa to Wilder. Wilder, Ribello, he has a fast break. He puts it up. And one. Oh, no. They do count it. And one. It looked like he called an offensive foul there for a second. Good job by Ribello to sprint by those Randolph defenders and get that and one.
And when you play a press like that, it is exactly what can go wrong. Stoughton can break it.
Stoughton breaking it for the first time tonight. They had real trouble with it before. Ribello sinks the free throw to give him a 9-point lead. 4.6 left in the third. Fernandez needs to get a shot up. They get to Murray. Murray, long three. No good. So after three, we're going to have a 34-25 Stoughton lead here from the Randolph Holiday Tournament.
back here for the fourth quarter, where Stoughton has opened up a 34-25 lead over Randolph. Stoughton is 8 minutes away from its second win of the season. The Black Knights at 1-3 are looking to improve to 2-3. I'm Jeffrey Pickett alongside Josh Brown, and Pat Jackman is filming the game for us. And Josh, what does Stoughton need to do in the fourth quarter?
Stoughton needs to play with a lot more poise. Stoughton did a good job opening up that 9-point lead late, but you can't count on Randolph having as bad a quarter as they had in that third quarter. So Stoughton needs to play with a lot more poise, a lot more composure, and if they can do that, they should have no problem kind of finishing Randolph off here.
Well, Randolph scored 12 points in the first quarter, and they scored 13 in the next two combined. So offensive points, tough to come by. To start the fourth, you have Korea Wilder. Gallagher's inbounding the ball. Manning, who has the ball now, and Rebello on the court for the Knights. Gallagher has the ball to Manning. Mike Manning looking to get it inside to Joey Wilder, and there's some contact. These first few possessions of the fourth quarter are key for Stoughton. They can really put the game away here. Joey Wilder at the line. No good, and the rebound goes to Randolph. Anthony Fernandez has the ball, Gallagher on defense. Fernandez trying to go to the basket. No good, and that's Korea with a rebound. Gallagher with the ball. Knights picking up the speed. Gallagher looking to go inside, loses the ball. Randolph comes up with it. And that's Fred Epps to the basket. That's just a nice move by Epps to the basket and converting for the score. And draws a foul. Epps at the line. Shot is good. It's 34-28 Stoughton. Knights have a 6-point lead with 7:28 left in this game. Randolph has been pressing all night. Rebello tries to break it. Dangerous pass there. Gallagher back to Rebello now. Rebello back to Gallagher. Randolph's defense all over Stoughton right now. Manning outside. 13 seconds left on the shot clock. Mike Manning gets it to Joey Wilder. Wilder working his way inside. Korea with the ball. Knocked away, and it's going to go out of bounds. I thought it went off on Randolph, though. I guess not. Randolph will inbound the ball. Another sloppy start to this quarter.
Stoughton with the height advantage now with Awesome on the bench. If Stoughton can put this game away before they can get Awesome back in, that would be big.
Austin, of course, has foul trouble for Randolph, so he's on the bench. That's Fred Epps with the ball. Epps going to the hoop again. Draw some contact. Hey, if you can't score and get the ball to go in, draw some contact.
Looks like Mike Gallagher did a good job there to take a charge. It looked like to me, I wasn't watching the whole play, but it looked like his feet were set when they came barreling into him. But, you know, calls go for you, calls go against you. You got to just roll with the tide.
So Epps at the line. Misses the first shot. 6:47 left in this game. And Epps makes the second one. It's a 5-point game now, 34-29. Mike Gallagher will be inbounding. Less pressure from Randolph so far in this possession. Say just gets it inside to Wilder, and Joey Wilder gets it to go. Nice move by Joey Wilder to the basket. Randolph looking to answer. Long range shot, no good. Sages with the rebound. Mike Manning now with the ball. Bringing it across the half court line. Mike Manning gets it back to Mike Gallagher. Gallagher throws it away. That was Dennis Rebello who couldn't handle the ball. I think Rebello's tapping himself right now saying, my bad. So, big turnover for Stoughton. They could have gone. They could have increased their lead. Instead, it remains 36-29. 6:14 to play. It's number 10, Anthony Fernandez, with the ball. Gallagher on guarding him. Joey Wilder nearly got that away, but instead, Brian Brazil goes inside and scores. Sages with the ball for Stoughton as it's a 36-31 game now. Sages inside to Wilder. Wilder looking to go to the bucket, draw some contact, but he's going to be called for a travel. So another turnover for Stoughton. That's two straight turnovers for the Black Knights. Randolph with the inbounds pass. Anthony Fernandez with the ball. To Matt Brown. Matt Brown tries to score, but shot won't go. Brazil, though, grabs the rebound. Jump ball.
If the refs are going to wait that long to call the jump ball, they have to call the travel that happened before that. If they let Brazil travel, and then they call a jump ball, questionable call there.
Especially where you kind of call the same thing on the other end of the court for Joey Wilder, against Joey Wilder. That's Fernandez with the ball. Brown now has it. Brown to Epps. Epps across to Brown. Brazil inside. Draws some contact.
And on the line for two, Brian Brazil.
Brazil's added some energy, Josh, coming into this game. He's seemingly be involved, has been involved on both ends of the court in every play. First shot, no good. Stoughton High Black Knights have a 36-31 lead with 5:26 left to play. Brazil about to attempt a second shot. This is the finals of the Blue Devil Holiday Classic. That shot is good. 36-32, Randolph back within four. Mike Manning inbounding the ball. Pressure by Randolph. They're on a full court press. Rebello with the ball. Pressure lightens up a bit. Bella brings it across half court. And a sloppy pass somehow finds its way to Joey Wilder. Can't finish it, though. And Randolph has the rebound. That's Epps working his way inside to Brown. And Brown gets it to go. It's 36-34. Timeout on the floor. Brown to Epps makes it a two-point game. And Randolph, after being stymied on offense in the second and third quarters, is starting to find a little bit of rhythm right now.
And Jeff, I don't know about you, but I would have Gallagher on the floor here for the rest, the remaining 5:03 here. Gallagher not in foul trouble yet, and I think if you're Stoughton, he needs to be in the game. He's your best ball handler, especially in a sloppy game. Like, it's like a surprise that he's not in the game right now.
34-25 game to start this quarter, and it's now 36-34. So Randolph on a 9-2 run. Randolph scored just 13 points in the second and third quarters, 9 in the first 3 minutes of the fourth. So it's the Randolph Blue Devils who have come out strong to start this final frame. Stoughton will need to respond here and settle down. Let's see who Coach Gallivan has coming back out as they break from this much-needed timeout to reset. Gallivan is going to go with Sages, Rebello, Wilder, Teixeira, and Manning, who will inbound the ball. Manning looking to inbound it. Pressure by Randolph. Gets it to Rebello. Rebello now passes it up to Wilder. Wilder, the pass got away, but Stoughton retains possession as it touched a Randolph player last. Mike Gallagher comes in for Teixeira. So it's Gallagher, Sages, Manning, Wilder, and Rebello on the court. Gallagher throws a toss-up, goes to Randolph, and it's a tie game. Fritz Oslin with the bucket and we're tied at 36.
Stoughton needs to get back and challenge him. Randolph's not a great free throw shooting team. They let him just walk in for the layup.
That pass led to that score. Gallagher's pass was intercepted. Wilder has the ball now, and it's getting loud in here. Sages, it's going to be offensive call against Stoughton. So another turnover for the Black Knights, and Randolph can take a lead now on this possession.
Jeff, a playoff-like atmosphere in this building. That's kind of nice for an early season game like this.
Sure, nice crowd on a vacation night. The night before New Year's Eve. So no school in either Stoughton or Randolph, of course. Nice showing here by the Stoughton crowd especially. Anthony Fernandez with the ball. Fernandez, Wilder is trying to draw a charge, but he can't. And that's Brazil. Bryant Brazil gives Randolph the lead. Manning with the ball for Stoughton. It's 38-36, Randolph with 4:15 left. Manning to Wilder. Wilder having trouble finding somebody to get the ball to. Tries to go inside and draw some contact, and he does.
Wilder stepping up and doing what captains do. He saw nothing really going on offense. He did a good job of taking it in his own, drawing the contact. Good job by Wilder.
Wilder at the free throw line. Gets a first to go. It's a 1-point game. 4 minutes and 5 seconds remain. No good. That's number 11, Fritz Austin, coming down with the rebound. Ron Harris controls the ball. Excuse me, that's number 3, Fred Epps, controlling the ball. Manning on defense. Epps gets it to Brown. Brown inside to Brazil, who's been a force in this quarter. And Brazil gets the two and draws the foul. Brazil has really stepped up in this fourth quarter for Randolph, and he's making the difference right now. It's 40-37, Randolph with the lead. 3:47 left in this game. Josh, what do you do to adjust to Brazil's presence in this fourth quarter?
It kind of makes you question why he wasn't in the whole first kind of three quarters of the game, really. Just coming in here, if you're Stoughton, you got to put more pressure. I mean, Wilder, it's tough because you come in with such a force, he's out of the game now if you're Stoughton.
And that's a costly turnover for Stoughton, though. Inbounds pass goes off of Mike Manning. So it's going to be Randolph ball on their side of the court. Randolph inbounding it. Gets it to Fernandez. It's Epps with the ball near the top of the key. Epps working his way inside. Loses it. Stolen by Sages. And Sages going to the basket. Stanley Sages blocked, but he draws some contact. Stanley Sages with a nice play.
That's a bad call there. Foul him off from out of the game. He's out of the game now. Great job by Sages to get that steal again for the basket. But to call that on Austin, that's a game changer right there.
Well, is it a call if it's his first foul of the game, or are you just saying that because it's his fifth?
I think it was a soft foul overall, but to call that foul on Austin, if you call that foul on Murray, I can see that more. Murray's the one who took the contact from Sages. Austin came from behind and tried to block it. I think that's a soft call on Austin.
Well, it's a tough break for the Randolph Blue Devils. Austin has fouled out. He's one of their two captains. Fred Epps is the other captain. So let's see how Randolph adjusts in this final 3 minutes and 32 seconds as they're without one of their top players. Stoughton out of this timeout. Going to go with Wilder, Gallagher, Manning. Sages is at the line in Korea. Big free throws coming up for Stanley Sages. Sages No good. It's two shots. Got to make your free throws here if you're Stoughton. Time is winding down. Sages does get the second to go, and it's a three-point game, 41-38. 3 minutes and 31 seconds left. Fred Epps with the ball, gets it to Brown. Brown looking for Brazil, but he's not open, so instead gets it to Fernandez. Fernandez gets it back out to Epps. 15 seconds left on the shot clock. Epps out to Brown. Brown inside to Brazil. Brazil out to an open Fernandez. Now he's covered. Fernandez trying to go inside, and looked like he might have traveled. Stoughton will get the ball. Just over 3 minutes left in this game. Mike Manning will be inbounding it. Manning to Gallagher. Loses it out of bounds, but touched a Randolph player last, so Stoughton ball. Wilder with the ball. Gets it to Sages. Sages inside to Wilder. Joey Wilder gets it to go. Stoughton's within one. Nice play by Joey Wilder. The two-pointer makes it a 41-40 game. 2 minutes and 45 seconds left. Brown with the ball for Randolph. Inside to Epps. Epps for two. Gets it. That's a tough shot. Credit him for making it there.
Yeah, the Epps just got in there. Stoughton played great defense there. He just was able to roll off that screen and get in.
Wilder with the ball. Seems to break this mini press. Now slows down to reset the offense. Mike Gallagher has it. Epps with the defense. Gets it to Sages now. Sages back out to Wilder. Wilder going inside again. Puts it up. And he gets it again. Joey Wilder. Huge play right there. It's 43-42. And Joey Wilder has put up two big shots in a row for Stoughton. 2 minutes and 6 seconds left.
And Wilder really carrying Stoughton right now, Jeff. If Stoughton can pull out a win here, game ball's got to go to Wilder after this performance.
Well, in these holiday type of tournament shots, they usually give out tournament MVPs and all-stars, and you would certainly have to think that Joey Wilder would have to be Stoughton's selection. But there's plenty of game left to play. 2 minutes and 6 seconds, it's a one-point game. Josh, what does Stoughton need to do on this possession?
Stoughton, offensively, they need to keep getting it down to Joey Wilder. If you have a hot hand, keep going with it. Defensively, they don't have to do much. They've done a good job of not letting Randolph get their jump shots up. Down low, Stoughton needs to kind of close off that box down there, something they've had trouble with. If they can do that, get rebounds like they've been doing all game, keep control of the ball, then Stoughton has a good chance of pulling this one out.
Randolph's ready to break the huddle. Stoughton will follow suit now. Knights come back out on the court. It's Correa, Wilder, Sages, Manning, and Gallagher. 2 minutes and 6 seconds left. Randolph with a one-point lead. Matt Brown will be inbounding the ball. Shamar Mari and Fred Epps are in the backcourt for the Blue Devils. Brown inbounding it, gets it to Epps. Correa with the defense. Epps will bring the ball across the half-court line. Just now 2 minutes to play. Gets inside to Brazil. Brazil going inside. Can't get it to go, but he gets the offensive rebound, and Brazil gets it to fall. And if Joey Wilder's been big for Stoughton, Brazil has been just as big for Randolph in this fourth quarter. Wilder with the ball for the Black Knights. He's dribbling it inside. Gets it out to Correa. Correa for three. In and out. Gallagher gets a rebound and gets it to go. Mike Gallagher with a key offensive rebound and goes to the hoop for the easy lay-in. It's 45-44 with a minute 25 left. Randolph with a one-point lead. Epps with the ball. Epps to Brazil. Brazil puts it up. No good. Correa with the rebound and gets it to Manning. Big rebound there for Stoughton. Manning pushing the ball up the court. He's fouled. two shots, and Mike Manning is one of your better free throw shooters. So key to get Mike Manning in the line right there. I'm sorry. So one. Two shots. Mike Manning, there's a little confusion whether that was a one and one or two shots. It's two shots for Manning. So Manning has a chance to give Stoughton the lead, just like he did last night against Natick. First one clanks out, he'll look to tie the game here.
If Manning doesn't make this, Stoughton needs to get back on defense. Transition offense has been big for Randolph. Stoughton needs to get back.
Manning, ready to take his second free throw attempt. Ball is up, and it's in. 45-45, Manning ties this game. 109 left. Epps with the ball. Buckle up, we're in for an exciting last minute of play here from the Blue Devils Holiday Classic. Championship up for grabs. Timeout, Randolph. 1 minute and 1 second left. We're in a 45-45 game.
Jeff, it should be a good finish here. Joey Wilder carrying Stoughton here. Brazil doing the same for Randolph. And we're set for a classic here from the Randolph tournament.
Josh, you've been near these type of huddles before as the team manager for a couple of years for the Stoughton High Boys basketball team. What's Coach Gallivan saying right now?
Coach Gallivan's talking about the defense, first and foremost here. I know he's trying to chalk something up to stop Brazil down low. He's really been hurting them. And, he's telling the team, stay composed. And, look for your shot. You have a minute and 1 second left. You're in a tie game. Look for your shot and play your game. And if you do that, then you're in good position here.
So the Knights ready to break the huddle. Let's see who Coach Gallivan puts out on the court. And it's the same five he had before the timeout. You have Sages, Correa, Wilder, Manning, and Gallagher for the Black Knights. Jose Correa playing some big minutes for Stoughton right now down the stretch. Fred Epps will inbound the ball around half court. Epps gets it in to Brown. Brown back to Epps. We're under a minute to play. Epps with the ball. 15 seconds left on the shot clock. Correa with the defense. Now Sages. Epps kicks it out to Brown. Brown going back inside. Brown can't get the shot to go, but Brazil gets a rebound and gets it to go. Brazil has been huge this quarter for Randolph. It's 47-45, and the pass is intercepted, but Wilder gets it back. Ahead to Correa. Correa blocked. He's blocked. Wow. Josh, did you see who got the block there?
It looked like it was a smaller guy, so either Epps or Brown got it. There was definitely a guard who got that block there. Great job by Randolph to hustle back and get that block.
Absolutely, because Correa looked like he had a chance at a fairly uncontested layup, and Randolph just came out and swatted the ball away. Big turn of events. There's 28 seconds left.
If you're Stoughton, Coach Galvin's telling them right now, they're trying to chin Epps and try to not get the pass to Brown. If they can get the inbounds to anyone else and foul quickly, that suits better for Stoughton, because Randolph's not a great free throw shooting team besides those two.
So you are looking for the quick foul, not trying to go for a steal.
Off the inbounds, I go for a steal right away, but you first and foremost, you got to prevent the pass to those two.
Randolph with a 47-45 lead, 28 seconds left. Correa, Wilder, Manning, Sages, and Gallagher still on the court for the Black Knights. Randolph with 22 points this quarter. They have found their touch, and it's come courtesy of Brian Brazil, who's been huge for Randolph. He's number 30. He's near Wilder, just outside the paint right now. Number 10, Anthony Fernandez will inbound the ball for the Blue Devils. Looking to get it to Epps. goes to Brown. Brown to Epps, and Manning fouls Epps right there.
Not what Stoughton wanted there. Brown and Epps were both wide open. Randolph's best two free throw shooters. Hopefully for Stoughton, they will have missed here.
25.7 seconds left, so the shot clock will be off for the rest of the game. You expect Stoughton to take a timeout after this?
Depends if the second is a make or miss. If Randolph misses the ball here, if I'm Coach Gallivan, I push the ball up court and try to get something.
So this is certainly an exciting finish to this game at Randolph High School, the finals of the Blue Devil Holiday Classic. Stoughton won the first game against Natick, 56-48. They're trying to sweep this holiday tournament and take the title, but they trail Randolph by two right now.
And they switch it now. It looks like they're saying the foul was on Manning, not Gallagher there.
It was on Manning. It looked like Manning, unless they called an off-ball foul. Big free throw right there. It's a three-point game. It's a huge free throw right now for Randolph. This would make it a two-possession game. And he does, makes it a two-possession game. 49-45, 25.7 seconds left. Gallagher with the ball. Stoughton needs to score twice. Gallagher looked like he was almost fouled. Gets it to Sages. Sages puts up a shot. No good. And Randolph comes up with travel. Randolph is going to be called for a travel. That's a great break for Stoughton. So Stoughton with 13.4 seconds left. They're still going to have to score twice. But at least they get another shot.
Don't need a three here.
They need to score quickly, though. That's for sure. Korea for three. He's open. No good. Stoughton fought for the rebound but can't get it. They're going to have to foul. And if Randolph can hit their fouls here, this game's all but signed, sealed, and delivered. Well, Korea had an open shot. It looked good coming off his fingers, but it just missed.
Just couldn't get the bounce. Good job by him to be aware to get open down there. Just couldn't get the fall. You know, it happens. He's a young kid, and what can you say? Randolph with a good job closing this game out late.
Well, Epps misses the foul shot, but Stoughton's going to have to ask for a lot to score twice. It doesn't really matter if he makes or misses this foul shot here. He makes it. It's 50-45. Timeout Stoughton. With 6.6 seconds left, Josh, walk me through what Stoughton has to do here.
That was a little bit of a better break than they made. And now if Randolph decides to bring everyone back, they can roll the ball on court. So that might have helped Stoughton a little more than hurt them there. If you're Stoughton, you're down five here. You have to take a three, make it, foul, and hope for a miss on one of them, push it up court. It's going to take a lot, like you said, but certainly we've seen weirder things happen, Jeff.
I don't see how Stoughton would finish this game off with a win without a turnover. They're going to need to intercept an inbound pass, something of that nature. I mean, Stoughton needs to score twice. They only have 6.6 seconds left. They're going to get the ball at half court at least, but it's just, you're asking a lot for Stoughton right now. Nonetheless, it's not the way Stoughton wanted to end this holiday tournament, especially where it took a 9-point lead into the fourth quarter. Randolph's offense, like I said, thanks to Brian Brazil, really coming alive in this fourth quarter. 25 points in the fourth. They had 25 points in the first three quarters. So 6.6 seconds left. Stoughton's hoping for a miracle. If not, they'll be 1-4 to end the 2013 part of their schedule. Stanley Sears with the inbounds pass. Gets to Gallagher. They're setting up a long range pass. Sages is going to take a three. Sages, no good. And Randolph is going to come away. They're fouled actually with half a second left. Thought they were going to be able to run the clock out there, but with a half a second left, Randolph will go to the line. That's Matt Brown. But this game is all but over. It's 50-45 Randolph. the first. Stoughton will fall to 1-4. They won the first game of this holiday tournament against Natick, 56-48. And Stoughton looked good for most of this game, but just slipped down the stretch here.
Yeah, Stoughton, not the end of the world losing here. You would have liked to have that one back.
And that's the game. The final score, Randolph 51, Stoughton 45. Stay tuned for post-game coverage.
This time we're going to announce our runner-up within our runner-up trophy to the Stoughton Black Knights. So if we can have the captains please come out and accept the award.
Joey Wilder and Stanley Sages coming out for the Black Knights to accept the runner-up runner-up plaque in the Randolph Blue Devils Holiday Classic. Former Stoughton assistant coach Kalon Jenkins, now the Randolph head coach, handing the trophy to the captains.
And it was at the championship trophy to this year's 2013 Blue Devils Holiday Classic.
Jenkins will present the holiday trophy to his own team.
At this time, we want to announce the all-tournament team for 2013. First, from Natick, number one, Alex Hilger.
No surprise there, Alex Hilger was
from
great.
From Bingham High School, Thomas Stitt. From Stoughton High School, Joey Wilder.
Joey Wilder, no surprise that the captain is the on the tournament all-star team. Played great underneath.
Also from Stoughton High School, Mike Gallagher.
Mike Gallagher also playing great these past two games for Stoughton.
And from Randolph High School, Oslin.
Fritz Oslin making the tournament team for Randolph.
And this year's 2013 Blue Devils Classic Tournament MVP goes to number three, Fred Epps.
Fred Epps with the tournament MVP, but well deserved. But not to have Brian Brazil on that all-tournament team, even if he just had one big quarter. That quarter made the difference, Josh.
Yeah, Brazil, great for them. Very obviously underappreciated here by the tournament team, but nothing can take away the quarter he had for Randolph. He was huge for them. Here with Coach Gallivan post-game. Coach, let's just talk a little bit about that game. Back and forth, got away at the end, but how do you kind of assess that game?
We talked earlier in the year about scoring. We don't need anyone to get 20 points, but we need like four guys to get 10. And tonight, you know, Joey had a good offensive game, but their defense took us out of our comfort zone. And at the end, that big kid just got so many putbacks on missed shots. Our failure to block out, pay attention to little details. We talked about it at halftime. We talked about it before the game. The little things take care of the big things. And tonight, the big thing took care of us. He was very impressive down the stretch.
Yeah, you mentioned Brian Brazil. Just how big of an impact in that fourth quarter did he have? Kind of carried Randolph, scored a good chunk of their points there in the fourth.
Yeah, he had, I believe he had 12 in the fourth quarter, and eight of them were on his own missed shots. So, we changed the way we usually front the post. We played it from behind, make him make a tough shot. He had missed the tough shot and then hit the easy one, and that was just too much. Because when you're worried about Fritz and you're worried about Epps, there's too many guys to worry about. It's a good team, well coached.
And not all bad. So you guys played good at points in the game. What do you kind of take away from that and bring into Franklin?
Hopefully you take the idea of a pressure atmosphere and not giving in to pressure, but fighting pressure with pressure. So when you're 30 feet from the basket and someone bellies up to you, you rip through and you go to the basket and you don't just back up because they're pressuring you. So this is a good environment for some young kids to learn. You know, we don't have the kind of talent to give away games. We need to close out a lot better than we did tonight, obviously.
So Randolph comes away with a 51-45 win. They win the Randolph Holiday Classic. Stoughton, it was a sloppy game for both teams. Both teams kind of, I'm sure if they could do it again, they'd change a lot of things about how they played. If you're Stoughton, it's not all bad, as Coach Gallivan alluded to in the post game. A lot Stoughton can take away from there, and Stoughton 1-4 at this point, and they go into Franklin hoping to improve that.
Thank you, Josh. So as you said, a 51-45 loss for Stoughton. Randolph scoring 26 points in the fourth quarter, key in their victory. Stoughton falls to 1-4. Thank you for tuning in. For Josh Brown and Pat Jackman, who did a great job again filming, I'm Jeffrey Pickett. Happy New Year.